So, let's start our story. Once upon a time, there was a man and his wife. They were very sad because they were wishing long for a child of their own. One day, a miracle happened. The woman told her husband that whatever they are wishing long for, they were going to have a baby. The man and his wife were very much overjoyed. The man and the woman lived in a small house with a small window in the kitchen overlooking a beautiful garden of fresh vegetables and fruits. Unfortunately, there was a high wall with barbed wire that no one ever climbed up there because the garden belonged to a mighty witch who everyone is so scared or terrified of. One day, as the woman was looking out of the window onto the garden, she saw a bed of fresh radishes. They looked so enticing that she began to want some. This went on for days. She knew that she could not get the fresh radishes to eat some. She was becoming more and more feeble by the day and day. Her husband was very worried about her. He asked one day, "My dear wife, what is the matter? Why are you so feeble?" The woman said, "My dear husband, I feel like I will die if I don't eat some of those fresh radishes that go in the mighty witch's garden." The man who loved his wife very much thought that he could rather get caught than losing his beloved. So he waited for the night to fall so he could climb over the wall and get a handful of radishes. Unseen by anyone, he sneaked into the garden and brought a handful of radishes, of fresh radishes, to his wife. His wife was very overjoyed. And also, she made a radish salad and ate to her heart's content. But it tasted so good that she began to want twice as the before day. The man had to climb again over the wall and get a handful of fresh radishes. But this time, as he was going back to his house, he saw the witch standing right in front of him. He was terribly scared when the witch yelled, "How dare you come into my garden and steal my radishes, my fresh radishes," she yelled. "Please don't judge me too hard. I did it for my wife," the man said. "She wanted your radishes so badly that she could even die if she did not have some of the radishes the before day." The witch said, "Well, if that is the truth, you may take as many as fresh radishes as you like. But on one condition." The man asked, "What is the condition?" The witch said, "I want your child. I will raise it like my own," she said. The man, terribly frightened, and said, "Okay, fine." And he promised the witch whatever she asked, he would bring him. So the time came. The baby was born. It was a baby girl. The witch appeared. She took away the baby and named her Rapunzel as she threatened. Rapunzel grew more and more beautiful by every passing year. On her 12th birthday, the witch locked Rapunzel in a tall tower without no stairs nor either a door. Rapunzel was so bored there living all day. So Rapunzel, when the witch wanted to come in, she called, "Oh Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair." Rapunzel had long, beautiful golden hair which shined like gold. When she heard the witch's voice, she loosened her plaits and let her hair down so the witch could climb up the tower because there was no door or any stairs. Rapunzel asked one day the witch, "Mother Gothel, I'm so bored staying at home. Please, can I go outside?" But the witch said, "No, you are not allowed to go outside. The world is a very dangerous place, my dear," the witch said. And one day, a prince was passing by the forest and came by the tower. He heard a sweet singing voice so beautifully. He followed the voice and came to the tower. It was Rapunzel. She was so bored that she began to sing, and even the birds would join her. She will make more feel better. But There was no stairs or nor any door for the prince to come in. So he went back to the castle, but he could not stop thinking of the beautiful girl's voice. The next day, the prince came again. As he was seeing how to get in the tower, he saw the witch come up. So he hid behind some bushes, and he saw the witch and also listened when she yelled, "Oh Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hat." And Rapunzel let down her head so the witch could climb up. So the prince thought, "Oh, that's the way in. That's how the witch comes up." The prince thought. The next day at dusk, the prince came again to the tower and shouted like the witch, "Oh Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hat." He sounded like the witch. So Rapunzel let down her head and the prince climbed up. Rapunzel was so scared when she saw a man enter her room instead of the witch. But the prince started talking kindly. "Don't be scared, my dear Rapunzel." Rapunzel asked the prince, "How did you know my name and how did you get up here?" The prince said, "I heard the witch calling you, 'Oh Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hat.' So that's how I shouted to you and you let down your hat so I can climb up." And the prince asked, "Will you marry me and be my wife?" The Rapunzel lost her terror and said, "Yes, I would, but I do not know how to get off here. You can get out quickly, but I cannot. So bring me a rope every dusk you come, and also I will make a ladder. And when it's finished, we will go to the other and you shall take me on your house. And also we will marry each other," she said. The prince agreed happily. And the witch did not know all of this was happening. Until one day, Rapunzel said to the witch, "Mother Gothel, why are you coming slowly to the tower while the prince can climb up in a moment?" Rapunzel asked the witch. The witch yelled, "What is this I hear? I kept you safe from a lot of wild dangerous. You have betrayed me." In anger, she cut down Rapunzel's head and she took her to a desert where there was no one, and she told, "You live here because you betrayed me." So she left Rapunzel there. At the same evening at dusk, the prince came and shouted, "Oh Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hat." But now, instead of Rapunzel, the witch let down Rapunzel's plaits and the prince climbed up to the tower. When he reached the window, he saw, instead of his dearest Rapunzel, he saw the witch standing in front of him with glittering eyes, so angry. And she said, "You will never see Rapunzel." And saying those words, she pushed the prince out of the tower and he fell into a bushes of sharp thorns. Now he was blinded. The thorns hit his eyes, so he wandered for years and years. Rapunzel could also not find the prince, and for the prince, he could not see or know where he was going. One day, until he heard Rapunzel singing and thought that it was his dearest Rapunzel. So he followed the voice because he could not see. He followed the voice, and when Rapunzel saw him, she was very happy, and both of them hugged each other tight after seeing many years. One of Rapunzel's tears dropped into the prince's eyes. Then the prince could happily see again. When the prince asked, "My dear Rapunzel, what happened to your hair? Did the witch cut your hair?" the prince asked. But while Rapunzel was about to answer, her hair grew back again, long and beautiful and shiny as it was before. So the prince took Rapunzel on his horse to the kingdom, and they married each other and lived happily ever after. The moral of the story is, you can never keep your children away.